video recently on landscape lighting, and you guys had more questions than I had answered in that video. So we're doing a second video to come back and try to answer some of those questions for you. And of course, if I don't answer all of them this time, we'll do another one, because I love it that you guys are asking all these questions. That's what we're here for. I'm sitting here on a job that we just finished, and of course it includes landscape lighting. You guys, if you have not considered landscape lighting on your job and in your landscape, please do that, because it really does make everything just feel like just, I know we use chef's kiss all the time, but it just, you know, like it just finishes it all off perfectly. So here we've got this little, people call it mushroom lights. It also is called garden lights or path lights. There's a lot of different names, which I know can get confusing when you're shopping for landscape lights, but we're gonna do the basic talk about landscape. We're not talking about houses right now. We're just gonna talk about in your landscape, and we're gonna talk about two different types that we have sitting right here and how they work in your landscape. So we've got these path lights or garden lights or mushroom lights as given their shape. And we're also gonna talk about up lights that you can see right here. How do you use them? Where do you put them, okay? So path lights are the easier of the two, in my opinion, to figure out how to use. These are basically just little bits of light along your landscape bed to highlight and just show that there's something going on back there, right? And around this patio, we use them to cast a little bit of light onto the patio surface and also into the landscape, so you can see that there's a difference between those two things. Now, I like to have them planted, I say planted, installed, about 15 feet apart is generally my rule of thumb, but of course I can always change. We like to put them close. This one you can see here is close to a pathway and the patio and this landscape bed. So we kind of split the difference, so it's highlighting all of those. If it was less than 15 feet, then I would add one here anyway. So you kind of have to think about the design in that way, where you don't have these hard, fast rules of thumb where you're putting them exactly 15 feet apart no matter where you are. You have to consider all the elements. Now, that being said, putting them too close is a problem. In my opinion, when you put these types of lights too close, you get what my mom calls the airport runway effect, which makes it look like you could run, you know, land your airplane on this sequence of lights that's really close together. So you want to be really careful to not get too crazy with putting too many of them out. So 15 feet, rule of thumb, kind of, but then again, keep in mind what you have going on in your landscape. Okay, now we're gonna talk about up lights. Oh, actually, let me go back to this one more time. These are also for smaller shrub areas as well. So you want to kind of cast a little bit of light on these shrubs here and smaller things. So that kind of segues me into, well, what do you do with trees? That's where these up lights come in. And you can see, Nate can get a shot of kind of how far away we are from this tree, but we're highlighting this tree, and this tree is about 5 feet away from this up light. So this is casting light up into the tree, and it's kind of gonna cast a light into the branch structure of the tree. And so that way you're gonna have this, imagine it at night, you've got this little bit of light here, and you've got this higher level of light. So even with the plants and everything else that has this height, you wanna create that visual height and differences at night. That's what we're doing with the light, right? It's this nighttime visual that you create that you just didn't have before when you just had this big blank space. Now, of course, third of all, if you want to get even higher, we could do cafe lights, or we could do some sort of moonlight down. But I told you guys, we're not talking about those. We're just talking about these two today. So these, again, back the rule of thumb, 15 feet-ish, these are very much according to what you have going on in the landscape, and you're creating that height. So if you have a larger tree on either side of the house, or you have a really special tall tree that you want to highlight, then that's when the up light comes out in. Now, of course, there's different sizes of these lights. There's various choices that come into play with up lights and things like that. There's different Kelvin temperatures, which I have a video about Kelvin temperatures and how to choose that. Generally, you guys know I like 2700K, 3000K is also good if you're talking about this low lighting that goes in your landscape. So I think that's all I have. We could talk for days and days about landscape light, but I just wanted to give you a few more tips to go off of. And of course, if you have any questions, be sure to comment below, and we'll do another video for you guys.